हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू एडुकेशनल गुरु। तो इस वीडियो में एग्जाम बोर्ड एग्जाम को ध्यान में रखते हुए मैं आप लोगों को सारे चैप्टर्स के इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स को कवर कर दूंगा, जिसके रिलेटेड आपके बोर्ड एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन अक्सर पूछे जाते हैं। आपको हर एक एक्सप्लेनेशन की पीडीएफ फाइल भी डाउनलोड करने के लिए मिल जाया करेगी। मैं डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में इसके लिंक दे दूंगा। चैप्टर्स रिलेटेड एक्स्ट्रा इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, मॉरल, थीम, टाइटल, कैरेक्टर स्केच के इंफॉर्मेशन भी मिल जाया करेगी आपको पीडीएफ फाइल के रूप में। आप उसे डाउनलोड कर उसे पढ़ सकते हैं और टाइम बचा सकते हैं दूसरे सब्जेक्ट को पढ़ने के लिए। मैं आप लोगों को चैप्टर्स के इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स को ही एक्सप्लेन करूंगा, जिससे रिलेटेड आपको एग्जाम में क्वेश्चन पूछे जाते हैं। आप एडुकेशनल गुरु के वेबसाइट को भी विजिट कर वहां से सारे इंफॉर्मेशन को डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं। और अगर आप मेरे इस चैनल पर नए हैं तो आपसे ये रिक्वेस्ट है कि आप मेरे इस चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करें, साथ ही साथ बेल आइकन को क्लिक करना न भूलें। तो सबसे फर्स्ट चैप्टर है हमारा टू जेंटलमैन ऑफ वरुणा। टू जेंटलमैन ऑफ वरुणा इज अ हार्ट वार्मिंग स्टोरी ऑफ ह्यूमन रिलेशनशिप एंड फैमिली बॉन्डिंग्स। मेन कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ द स्टोरी आर टू यंग ब्रदर्स नेम्ड निकोला एंड जैकोपो, रिस्पेक्टिवली 13 एंड 12 ईयर्स ओल्ड। This story explains how the two brothers devoted themselves to a hard and difficult life to earn money for the treatment of their sister. She was suffering from tuberculosis of the spine. The author met the boys on the outskirts of Verona and got impressed by their sincerity and devotion. The boys were dressed shabbily in old clothes and they were selling strawberries. Two boys, Nicola and Jacopo. Two young boys stopped the narrator on the outskirts of Verona. They were selling wild strawberries. The elder brother, Nicola, was 13, while the younger brother, Jacopo, was nearly 12. The narrator was strangely attracted towards them. He bought their biggest basket in spite of Luigi's, his driver, unwillingness and moved towards city. Next meeting of the writer with the boys. The next morning, the narrator found the two brothers signing shoes outside their hotel. The boys told him that besides picking fruit and signing shoes, the two boys also worked as tour guides. They proved extremely useful to the narrator and his driver Luigi. They could buy a pack of American cigarettes or seats for the opera. They could be relied upon to satisfy their needs. Waiting for the last bus to sell newspapers. One night, the narrator saw both the brothers resting on the stone pavement. It was nearly midnight. Nicola told the writer that they were waiting for the last bus from Padua. They could sell all their papers when the bus came in there. The narrator thought that they must earn quite a lot. They worked so hard and ate so little. They spent nothing on their clothes, the narrator thought. That perhaps they were saving up to immigrate to America. But they did not want to discuss anything with the writer on this topic. Narrator drives Nicola and Jacopo to Polita. The author was to leave Verona on Monday. He asked the brothers if he could do anything for them before leaving. Jacopo told that every Sunday they made a visit to the country to Polita, 30 kilometers from there. Usually they hired bicycle to go there. He asked the narrator if he could take them there in his car. Luigi had the Sunday off, but the narrator answered that he would drive them out himself. The following afternoon, they drove to the tiny village. The two brothers came out of the car and went toward the red-roofed villa. They promised to be back within an hour. Lucia, suffering from tuberculosis of the spine. After a few minutes, the narrator followed the boys inside. The narrator found a grilled slide entrance. He determinedly rang the bell. A pleasant-looking young woman appeared in the white uniform as a trained nurse. She led him into the hospital. She stopped at the door of a little cubicle. She asked him to look through the glass partition. The two brothers were seated at the side of a girl about 20. She resembled her brothers. She was listening to the chatter. The nurse asked the narrator to go in. Lucia would be pleased to see him. The The narrator did not want to intrude upon that happy family party. He begged that nurse to tell him all she knew about those boys. Family destroyed by the war. Nicola and Jacopo were quite alone in the world except their sister Lucia. Their father was a widower. He was a well-known singer and was killed in the early part of the war. A bomb had destroyed their home and they were thrown into the streets. They suffered horribly. They faced starvation and were exposed to cold winter. They hated the Germans who brought all these troubles for them. When the war was over, they came to their beloved sister. They found her suffering from tuberculosis of the spine. Sacrifice, sincerity, and devotion to the cause. The boy did all that they could do for their ill sister. They brought her to the hospital and persuaded them to take her into the hospital. She had made a lot of progress in the last 12 months. It was hoped that one day she would walk and sing again. Lucia brothers used to pay weekly bills. The narrator was shocked to know that the story of the two boys and their sisters. He hurriedly came out and waited until the boys rejoined him. He drove them back to the city. They sat beside him and spoke nothing. Even he didn't say a word to them. He knew they would prefer to feel that they had safely kept their secret. Their devotion, selfless action, and sincerity touched his heart deeply. Their devotion to the cause brought a new nobility to human life. They gave a new hope for humanity. So, students, this was the summary and main explanation of the main topics. I hope you will like it.